Hello everyone, Parallel here, and welcome to Blade and Soul. We are here playing during the Head Start, and it's going to be going live in just a couple of days. I'm here on my Gon Destroyer, and I'm here with my co-op partner on her Lyn
Summoner. Yeah. Hi everyone.
And we've just gotten to level 22, and we thought we would do a co-op run of the Blackram Narrows, which is the first kind of main dungeon slash instance that you get to. We've tried this once so far, so we're a little bit familiar with the mechanics, but that is it. And right now our gear is pretty much terrible. As you can see, we haven't even done the second breakthrough on our weapons, so our DPS is pretty low. In fact, that we've been running this dungeon in order to get the Blight Axe and the Blight Staff for Lyn, so we can actually upgrade our weapons. So our gear is pretty much terrible, but we were able to co-op through this once and at least get a basic idea of the mechanics of the dungeon. So yeah, so we thought we'd run through this and show everyone what this dungeon is like. And okay, let's go ahead and let's dive right in. And we'll kind of talk about it as we're going here. Oh, another guy coming.
A loot action has started.
Ooh. We already got a blue thing.
Yeah.
You want it? I'll just pass. Go ahead.
Oh, thanks.
You're welcome. So for this part, looks like a bunch of ads, but actually Dochin comes along and destroys them all. Well, most of them anyway. Alright, so up here is kind of the first, I guess he's a mini-boss, he doesn't really drop any loot, but he is a Force Master, and he has kind of an ice AoE that he drops on the ground that you gotta be careful of, and it does a lot of damage, especially with our crappy gear. Alright, so I'll jump in, let's take down the adds really quick, as fast as possible, and then I'm probably have to get out of his ice thing pretty quickly, so, alright, ready?
Mm-hmm.
Freeze me. Well, not too bad. I'm done bleeding some healing targets. Yeah, see, he doesn't drop any decent loot, unfortunately. But yeah, the Destroyer and Summoner, we've been having a lot of fun. It seems to be a pretty good team, actually. We have a lot of knockdown capability. Like, I've got two knockdowns that I can stack, one on a pretty short cooldown, and you have a knockdown, don't you? I'm gonna heal up here.
Yeah, my cat has like a big sword that she pulls out.
Your cat has a knockdown? What's the cooldown on that?
It's 18 seconds.
Oh, okay, so yours is kind of long. Mine is a lot shorter than that. My kick knockdown is only like 8 seconds or something like that. Okay, so yeah, I just got a level 22, I got my number 4 ability. And go ahead, you can take that one. That loot. Yeah, I got my number 4 ability, which is a leg sweep. And also does, if you do it during a grab, it will throw them up in the air and then let you do the pile driver, which I really want to try. I haven't got a chance to use that a whole lot yet. Go ahead and pull this guy back a little bit. I think we did that last time and it worked okay. This guy's a kung fu master, basically. Yeah, there we go. That was the pile driver. I'm still trying to work on my animation. Oh, crap. I'm dazed and ow. You want that? You need more unsealing charms than I do, actually. You can take that. But yeah, so far so good. The Destroyer has been a lot of fun. We have tons of grabs.
A loot action has started.
Oh, Viridian Stone. You can have
you
it.
You have withdrawn from another the auction. Party member has won the bid. All auctions have ended.
But Destroyer has been great. A lot of grabs and holds, a lot of cool moves. And even a couple of life-stealing abilities where when you grab them and you just press your F and hold it down, that will give you some life back. And also when you use your block, which is your V skill, which has kind of a long cooldown. But when you have that and then use your left click, that will also regenerate a good amount of health. Oh yeah, there's one of these dragon coils. Yeah, dragon coils. These things are really nice. When you see these in a dungeon, as you can see down here, it fills up a little heart, gives you dragon blood. That means if you ever die, it will use one of these charges and then bring you back to life. And we probably will need it on this boss. We had a little bit of trouble with him last time. But you can see the boss is kind of there in the middle here. Let's see if I can pull these guys back a little bit. I don't want to add one. Yep, so definitely clear out this room first we found. And so the only thing to really worry about with this boss is he summons a bunch of adds. And we found that, I mean, the first time we tried this, we kind of got wiped because we got overwhelmed by the adds. But as long as you take care of the adds pretty quickly, it wasn't too much of a problem our second try. So
yeah.
Let's give this another try here. Okay, when the two wolves go in, I'll come in and... Oh crap. So here's one of the adds. They're good to use to get your health up.
Over here, it's easier for me to get to watch dogs that like some of the guys.
Okay, here's another one. Ooh, a bomb. I'm gonna take this. Oh my gosh, it did like 8,000 damage. I didn't even see my character. There we go.
Yeah.
I pressed F. Why didn't I do anything? Sweet.
Yeah, definitely easier than last time.
Yeah, that was a lot better.
A loot action has started.
Sealed earring. Do you need that?
An earring? No.
Yeah, you need it to feed into your other ones. Sealed blight earring. I think I already have. Oh no, I have the necklace. Okay.
You have made a bid on the auction. The next auction will start.
Blade Soul Shield. I actually do need that one.
You have made a bid in the auction. All auctions have ended.
Sweet. So yeah, these you get new Soul Shield pieces in here that are way, way better than the previous ones. As you can see right here, my current one gives 10 hit points. Let me unseal this one. And you see this one gives 80. It's a ridiculous amount of upgrade. And it's also a set piece, which is really, really nice. But yeah, if you're coming in here with what we had been using was the soul shields you get from that first outdoor boss in the initial zone, and you spin the wheel and get those soul shield pieces. Those are pretty terrible. When we were going through this dungeon the first time with that gear, we were getting, you know, one shot by like almost everything. It was pretty bad. Did you lose a charge of your thing? Can you use that one again?
Yeah, I used it.
Oh, you used it. Sweet. Okay, so you got two charges. Awesome. All right, going good so far. Let's keep clearing. I don't think we need to kill those dudes over there. This was another boss, but I don't remember this guy being very hard.
No, he like jumps away.
Oh, that's right. He jumps away and then he brings in another guy. Okay. Grab him. Is your knockdown up?
Yeah.
Get ready. Sweet. And throw him up in the air.
Wow, good job.
Yeah, that's awesome. That's probably the best thing about Destroyer, honestly. Here, you can take his loot. We can, you want to heal up?
Yes, thank you.
Yeah, it's probably one of the better things about Destroyer is they get so many grabs and holds that they can keep even a boss down quite a bit. And I don't know if you notice, as we've been fighting these bosses, in this game, bosses are kind of similar to Wildstar, where they have interrupt armor. So you have to stack up two of the same kind of CC in order to actually get a lockdown on them. And since we have so many knockdowns, if I do one of my knockdowns, then you use your cat knockdown.
Yeah.
And then I can do a grab. It works really well. Wait for these guys to come back a little bit. Oh, I thought they were linked. Got a couple seconds. Okay, never mind. And this guy, another mini boss, but I think he's pretty easy. Do you want to eat a dumpling?
I am. I was waiting to get out of combat. Jeez.
Okay. You're doing good. Are those dumplings delicious?
They're so delicious.
What the heck? Oh no, it didn't let me do it. Oh, did he like jump away?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. That's why I couldn't do it. So are they like hurting you a lot, or are you healing your pet? No, he stunned me. Oh crap. Let's beat this guy up a bit, too. Doing a little spin to win here. Yeah, summoners are incredibly awesome too. We make a pretty good team. Her cat can somewhat tank. And you can heal. Oh, let's get this guy. Oh yeah, I did 1200 damage. That's pretty good. But yeah, that new pile driver, the number 4 ability for Destroyer is pretty sweet. You get that at level 22. Okay, and this is kind of two mini bosses. One's a Force Master, one's a Kung Fu Master. What do?
We turn down the Force Master.
You want to kill a Force Master first? Yeah. Probably a good idea. I think that's what we did last time. It seemed to work. Alright, ready? See, that's pretty crazy how long of a lockdown you can get from that. Wow, we destroyed them. Ooh, we can each get one. Okay, these guys. So that's up here is the next boss. This one is pretty hard. I'm thinking, especially the initial part when before you can take out the two adds are pretty difficult. And while you're trying to focus on them to get rid of them, the captain, she's a blade master, I think. Is that what it is?
Yeah.
Yeah, she's a blade master. She has all kinds of fancy moves, gets behind you. I think she has some like knockdowns and stuff. So yeah, it was pretty difficult. Just especially that initial part. I think I did lose one or two. Well, I think one heart last time. So what do you want to do? You want to focus on the black.
Yeah, black.
One of the black clothes.
Yeah.
All right, let's do that. Let's. There's my block, and when you attack with it up, it does give you a little bit of life back. Oh my god, closer's down. Yes, got her. Oh. Sweet. Good job.
Oh, you too, buddy.
Oh yeah, that's right. There's a bunch of dudes that come killing. We were trying to loot last time, and then they came in and, like, almost killed us. Alright, let's see what we get. What's this one? Earring. This is, like, one you can feed in. Just a blue. You want it? Blight necklace, I already got that. You can get that. That one I might already have. Yes, it's all yours.
You have another party member has won the bid. All auctions have ended.
So check out that soul shield piece. That should be a really big upgrade. You should unseal. Go ahead and unseal it. Yeah.
What do you want me to use? The regular one or the hot moon one?
You just use a regular. It's fine. So you go from 10 HP to 140, and 6 defense to 21 defense.
Yeah.
That's an insane upgrade. So you can get a lot of upgrades in this dungeon. Lots of good soul shield pieces. And this is, you know, like I was saying earlier, if you want to get your breakthrough for your weapon, you're going to need that blight. The blight weapon, the end boss does drop one blight weapon, and I believe a box that also has a random chance to get one. I think if you use the one of those brilliant keys on the box, it guarantees getting it. But those are the keys you have to get from the, I think you have to pay real money for those.
Of course.
Yeah, and this guy should look familiar if you've been playing through the storyline. Actually, he's kind of lucky. He doesn't... I don't think he has that move, like when you're fighting him.
Yeah, he doesn't even do
that. That can be pretty bad. He'd like knock you off the edge.
Yeah.
All right, so let's do this guy. This guy did give us some problems. In particular, this guy has a kind of a choke.
Yeah, he like continually grabs you in and like holds you. And it's like
it
over
and
over again.
It does a ton of damage.
Yeah.
Might be a little better now that we have a couple of soul shield pieces to give us a little more hit points, but when we were doing this the first time, his grab would literally take off 90% of your health. And he does get some... He basically has two phases as well. His first phase is in his current form. Once you kill this form, he changes into another form and powers up a little bit, has a couple extra moves that he gets. But we can kind of go through those as they happen in the game. You also have to watch out for these fiends.
They kind of blow up and take all your health away.
Yes, they run towards you and then they suicide on you, take off a lot of damage, and they kind of slow you down, so it's even harder to get away from stuff. So be careful of those. So we'll take them out right away and then focus on the boss. Do you have two
I have two charges
left?
Yeah.
Two dragon blood. All right, so let's take out these fiends. Okay, and you already did that. See, and I don't. None of my escapes work on this. I press 1 or 2 and it doesn't do anything. And there goes like 9% of my health. Did that already kill you?
It almost did. If I did, if I did not have that shield piece, I probably would have died. Because it, like, would automatically kill me last time.
Okay, that was close. So definitely when you see the red circle on the round, you gotta get out of there. Why is he resisting all my stuns? Okay, I'm gonna try to interrupt him. There we go. If you have a teammate, you can interrupt him when he does that choke on your friend. Jumping all over the place.
Oh, she's
I do have my... Oh, crap. No, that's not too hard. It's not too hard to avoid that one. But I do have my whirlwind spec for a little bit of increased movement speed, which is very nice for getting out of those circles. He's jumping all around. Okay, I'm out of things. I can't. I'm out of focus. I couldn't use my thing. Sweet. Now so far going a little bit better.
Oh, just a little bit.
So here's the thing now. When he grabs...
This is disgusting.
Yeah, that is pretty gross.
Like, he turns into a fish person. Like, how is that even possible?
He gets long fingernails, too.
Is that the only thing you're, like, paying attention to? His long fingernails?
Yeah, he might scratch you with those.
Oh, no. It's not like he's, like, a really ugly fish thing.
He's got a mouth in his stomach.
The staff. My cat? What the heck?
I did something to your cat, but I did my interrupt and he like didn't do it. Okay, as soon as charged, let's get out of there. There's a dead cat next to your live cat.
I know, that happened last time too. Like, it's kind of funny.
What the? Why is he like up on the wall?
I feel like that happened last time too.
What's going on? Oh crap. Summoning some fiends. Ah, man, when he grabs him with a fiend, kill that fiend. Thank you. Back up this one.
Okay, no thank you.
Get out of there. See, they slow you down when they do that.
Yep.
Can you pull your cat back? I can't like hit him when he's up there.
Oh, my cat's dead, so... Oh, I'm gonna die. Oh, maybe not.
Okay, I'll just pull him back a little bit. No.
Okay. Oh, that was great.
Are you still alive?
Yeah. So I have 8 health left. So.
Use some potions and stuff. You can use them.
Oh no! Girl, thank you. No, I was just about to use.
I can't interrupt that all my time.
Just, need to go.
Now your cat's back up. That's a good thing.
Yep.
Finally got him. Okay, I'm gonna go take him in the middle. Kill that. God, that slow lasts for a long time.
Cat's dead body is like hilarious.
You can get up.
Yeah, but please tell me he's not charging towards me.
He's doing his charge that way, so he should be fine.
Okay, well, I got 10 seconds.
Ah, I can do it.
They're starting to do the cannon, so we've got them down.
Oh, I did it, but it didn't let me pick him up. Oh, crap. There's a potion here. Did we get him?
Yep, we got him.
my explosives.
Oh, they did it. They're so good.
Thank you. Sweet, you did it.
Get out! This place is going to blow! Come! This way!
How does he know it's gonna blow?
He's so intuitive that he just knew.
Wait! General Kovan.
So when a black cloud comes, that means that everything's gonna explode.
Yeah. Don't you know? Like, this is common knowledge, isn't it?
Hurry!
Yes, bring that box.
Yes, we need it. Bring it.
Oh, he did the anime jump.
Oh, man. I love how we're, like, nowhere to be seen.
There's two more.
What's he thinking? He's gonna die!
He's gonna get sucked in.
Oh, no. Did he make it?
Yes, he did, because he's standing right here. Hi, Dochin. And actually, it's a good thing you did get that box, because that's how you get your reward.
Yep.
All right, here we go. What do we get? Necklace. It's just a blue one. Do you want it?
Yeah, I'm gonna beat it.
You have withdrawn from the auction. Has won the bid.
Locked bronze offering.
You have withdrawn from the auction.
Let me. That one I do need, actually.
You have won the bid.
Yes, play X. Let me. You have won the bid. Sweet. Sweet. So yeah, that's awesome. I got the play X. So that means I am going to. Let's see if I can do the breakthrough here. So you gotta unseal it. And I don't. Am I stuck in combat? Are you in combat?
No. Or yeah, I guess I am. I don't know why.
Well, we can. Let's get out of here. You'll lose all progress in. Oh, wait.
What do we need to do?
Did you claim that reward? Devourer's treasure. Oh yeah, okay, that's the one that gives you a random chance to get a locked blight weapon chest.
Yeah, I got one.
So if I open this, you got a locked blight weapon chest.
Yeah.
So if you unlock that blight weapon chest, you might, that's another chance to get your blight weapon for your class.
So my staff.
Yeah, go ahead and try to open it, why not? Let's see if you get it. Just use a regular. Well, yeah, we don't want a brilliant. If you have a brilliant key, then it guarantees that it's for your class.
I got the staff. That's hilarious.
Sweet. Awesome. So yeah, next time we run this, it's gonna be way better. Okay, let's get out of here and let's do the upgrade. We can show that. How to do a breakthrough on your weapon. If you've gotten to this point, you probably have broken through your weapon at least once. The first one to get is pretty easy.
Isn't it like part of a quest? I thought it was.
You can get it from those random boxes from the first world boss. It just has to be from your class, so you have to open a couple of them, but it's so easy to farm that first world boss that it's pretty easy to get yours for your class. Alright, so let's try it now. So all you have to do is shift click on your weapon. And we'll need to identify it first. Let's identify it. Yep, shift click on your weapon. And it takes Viridian Transformation Stones. And we got these. I'm trying to remember where we got these. Did we get this from the quest or from the daily spin?
Yeah. Maybe. I'm not sure.
But let's go ahead and do that. Use this heroic item as an offering. Oh, you do it. Okay, I will use Did you type use?
No, I'm putting stuff up jewelry right now. Do it in a second.
Okay. Feed it in your staff. I don't see what it looks like. Might be really cool.
Do I have to unseal it?
Yeah, sweet. Check this out.
Daddy, do I unseal it?
Yeah, unseal it. And then shift click on your weapon.
And then this is it. It like automatically puts it in? Or what?
Yeah, it automatically put it there and then to use your ingredient. Yep. Evolve. And confirm.
Did it do it?
Do it. Do it one more time. Say, I have to type use for some reason.
Maybe they're like, what if you like accidentally did it?
Yeah,
maybe
I think that's why they do that.
Important.
Yeah, I think that's why they have a confirmation.
All right, let's see. Oh, I can't actually look at mine. Never mind.
What? Put it on.
Why can't I? Oh, put it on. Why? Where is it? Oh, okay. Look how cool that is. It's a
so let's take a look at it.
Thing. He's holding a bell. That's funny.
Dragon with a bell hanging out of his mouth. That looks cool.
And he has like ram horns. It's like a dragon ram holding a bell. It's an interesting.
That's quite an interesting combo. Yeah. Sweet. So that's awesome. So now we can start feeding all of our other weapons into this one. Very nice. Very nice. Sweet, so that's awesome. So that we got our upgrade and completed the Blackram Narrows. Hopefully everyone enjoyed that. I did want to show one thing real quick before we go, and that is the Daily Dash. Because I noticed they actually made a few changes here from... They've actually changed this a few times since closed beta, but this time around, the way they've done it is... I mean, the spinning works the same way, but they changed the path on the board. Where it used to be, there used to be an item on every step of the way, but when you would spin the wheel, you would only get the one that you landed on. But in this one, it looks like they've kind of interspersed items throughout the path a few spaces apart, but now you don't have to land right on it in order to get that item. You just have to roll, you just have to advance past it. Even if you go over it, it will still get the item. So it's pretty good compromise, I guess. I like the way they did this because then it's kind of funny. In the old system, it was almost encouraged to roll less because then you could get, you know, each item from every step along the way. Whereas this one, it's actually good to roll a high roll because every time, even if you pass over the top of it, you will still get it. You don't have to land right on it. And at the very end here, you do get a Regium Corvus is the gear that you get. So you get a cool... a cool outfit, Regium Corvus. I think it's actually in, let me see if I can preview this here. Yep, here it is. So there it is, that's what you get at the end of the Daily Dash. Pretty cool looking outfit. You can preview it on some other ones here, so the djinn. It has like a little cape.
Yeah, a little dangle.
Yep. And on the Lyn. Actually, it's very similar on all three. Some of the outfits actually look pretty different depending on the race, but this one looks pretty similar on all three, I think. Or all four, I mean. All four races. All right, well, that is it, everyone. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you're having fun with the Head Start and Blade and Soul. And if you're wanting to check this out, the official launch, I believe, it's in like 2 days... which is, what is the date? 17th, I believe it's on the 19th, and you can start playing at midnight. So there you go. If you want to check this out, it is free to play. If you want to get in it for the Head Start, you do have to buy the Founders Pack, and I think they're almost done selling those. I think as soon as the launch date happens, they stop selling the Founder Packs. So, but yeah, if you just want to wait, that's fine, because then you can join when it's totally free to play on the 19th. All right, that's all. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.